Hey guys, so we're going to be playing the Black White Pestilence deck, the Creature Light version, for the Pauper Challenge today. We are running four Pestilence and the four Guardians of the Guild Pact, as well as two Palace Sentinels and one Invocar's Justice for win conditions. The rest of the deck is just all removal and hand discard. I played this deck a few times. There's just a few cards that are variants over here. And then in the sideboard, we're playing two Fragmentize, two Disenchants for Affinity slash Enchantment decks. Then we got two Circle Protection Blue, two Circle Protection Reds, and then we also have two more Duresses for Spell Heavy decks, another Castigate in case, mainly for like Tron and decks that are like much bigger than us. And then two Nihil Spell Bombs for Graveyard Hate, and three Rancid Urds for Tron. But yeah, this is the deck. Thank you very much. I hope you guys enjoy the video. Also, if I could ask you real quick, please hit the like button. It does help out the video quite a bit. And yeah, it helps to get the channel more notoriety. And, it just helps me out a lot. And I appreciate it for everyone who does that. Thank you very much for watching. And I'll see you guys in round one. Hey guys, welcome to round one of Pauper Challenge. We will keep this. Right, so we are playing against Burn. Okay. So that will help gain life. Yep. That sucks. We'll play this and we will Chainer's Edict. We need one more removal and I'll feel pretty good. Untap land wouldn't be terrible either. Yeah, we'll just go Pristine Talisman. That sucks. I think we're dead. I think we're gonna lose this one. So we'll go Bajuka Bog, targeting them. Save us two life. Play that. We just drew too many lands. We'll be better post sideboard. That's a game. All right, well, that was fast. So we got Castigate's fine. Circle of Protection red, Circle of Protection red. Duresses. Pestilence out. Invocar's Justice out. The rest should be fine, I think. Yes, we would like to play first. Mulligan. We'll keep this. We will get rid of Radiant Fountain. Gain two life. Alright. Gain another life. Yep, but we can counteract that with Pristine Talisman, so I think we're in an okay position. Pristine Talisman, gain a life. Yield through this turn. Play a land, pass turn. We need one more Pristine Talisman, it'll feel pretty good. Or some sort of creature. We will read the bones. Bottom, top, play that, play Circle of Protection, that should be game. Yep. 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 Okay, and prevent that. Play land. And that should, we should be able to grind out the game from here. Not. We want to do Castigate. Take a Skewer of the Critics, sure. Bajuka Bog, targeting them. Yep. Tap the whites. All right, pass turn. Go up to 9. Knight's Whisper, gain another life, gain some more life, castigate, I guess. Take chain lightning, I guess. He can't win at this point. I don't know what he's doing. But alright, he's just gonna play it out. Wait to use Pajuga Bog, I guess. Now we're at 18. Screw it, why not? Save ourselves some time. Okay. Deadweight that guy. Pajuga Bog targeting them. Read the bones. Bottom. We're just looking for threats. That is a threat. Alright, so he scooped. Again, let's make sure. Yeah. Yep, alright, we're good. All right, we'll keep this. Please no, okay, good. I'm fine with that. If we just get a lava runner, I was just worried about the 0-3. We're gonna castigate. No, we don't. We're gonna take hella damage. We'll journey in nowhere. Targeting that. Okay. Let's take that. Castigate. Take lightning bolt, that one's the strongest. Game three already. Rift bolt. And chain lightning. Okay. And hopefully we're not dead. Seven. Here are the critics. Go down to five. Duress is cool. I like that. Okay, so he's top deck mode. And I think we're in an okay spot. And that's pretty much game at that point. This is so good. Broken. Broken S cards, guys. Circle of Protection red. So the last game, it took me 25 turns to win the game because he went scoop after I had Circle of Protection out to find a creature. But yeah. That's pretty much a lock.
I hope you lose.
It's not gonna happen at this point, dude. Sure, that's fine. Okay. And there's the win con. Okay. Guess I'll draw some more. Bottom, top. Gain two life. Right. And yeah. Happens. You okay there, Chris?
Dying.
Why are you dying?
Mesothelioma.
Makes sense, makes sense. It's Whisper. I already played a land. Alright. Attack for 4. Pass turn. And attack for 4. And that's game. Alright, see you guys in the next match.
Yeah.
Welcome round 2, guys. Yeah, we're mulling the shit out of this. Because that's just who I am.
What if you have children watching?
Well, I mean, they probably shouldn't. I will keep this hand, though. What are we playing against? Alright. I kind of wanted to rest turn 1, so that's what I'm going to do. They went top-bottom with Pyridane. I know you want to say something, Chris, so just say it.
Oh my gosh.
So we're playing against Tron? No, this is the blue-white, the USA like aggro deck? Okay. Can't believe I hit 0 fucking instants and sorceries on that one. I'm garbage. Okay. Play that. I could have hit Arkham's Astral Blade, but nope. Of course they top decked that. Seeker of the Way is a thing. Go curious, yeah. Journey in Nowhere. Okay. Well, we will go land. We will Chainer's Edict. This is going pretty well so far for us. I think they already, yeah, they played the planes already. So I know 2 of their cards. Blanthawk's a thing. All right, so. Yeah, we're definitely not playing that. But we will play a Pestilence. Or will we? Now let's Chainer's Edict real quick. Okay. I want to get one more land so I can go Pestilence and like wipe his board in one turn. He is currently 7 cards ahead of us, though. Which is kind of scary. Pestilence. If he counterspells that, that's. God damn, I should have played it the turn before. I'm so retarded. Demir, why am I retarded?
It's okay, you can still. Maybe
pull.
Nah, it's over.
Yeah, I'm so dead. If he goes Ghostly Flicker, that's gonna. Oh yeah. Yeah, that's a
oh
thing.
Oh my god, this man's a madman.
Yeah, I think. think I lost this. I should have just played Pestilence before. Yeah, that did not happen. Cool Chainer's Edict. We're in trouble. I think we're gonna lose this first game. Yep. Okay, Pestilence off the top. That is not Pestilence. That's 8. He just needs 2 spells and 7, so why? Yeah, we're done.
Holy crap.
Okay, so what do we want? Dresses? To make sure Pestilence gets in this time? I don't really like Palace Sentinel in this matchup. We could do Disenchant, but I don't really think it hits. Like, attacking the artifacts is not really the way you want to go. I think this is fine. Let's try this. That deck's really strong, though. That's the first time I've played against it. I haven't played Popper in a little while. Guess I would like to play first. Keep. Duress. Just take Counterspell. Scred's a dead card against us. We'll Night's Whisper, see if it comes through. It does. We'll just play a regular land then to not have to discard. We're just drawing straight lands though, which does not make me feel good at all. Yep, that happens.
Where's your god now?
Yeah.
Deadweight that. Bajuka Bog, targeting them. Top bottom. Okay. Trainers eating them. Ballistica. Bring back Bajuka Bog. Pass turn. So much land. Skyfishers. Relic, sure. And we draw land again. He's gonna just use Exhumerate, but I mean, Expermate? I can't pronounce that. Yep. Oh, he just let it go? Okay. Pass turn. I mean, that happens. This is gonna hurt. So we basically need Pestilence and him not to have a counterspell. Yeah. Alright, so that will buy us some time. Play land. Pass turn. So we'll effectively take. Three a turn, so that buys us. So we have three turns to try to. Basically get Pestilence. We have less than that now. Alright, let's go for it. Hope he doesn't have a counterspell. If he doesn't, that would be amazing, but I'm pretty sure he does. And that's game. Alright. So you guys in match three. Alright, let's see if we can do a little bit better. Round three. Yes, we would like to go first. We will keep. And no possible play. Alright, well, we're probably screwed again. Alright, so this one's just a red-white version. Okay. So, barons with Chainer's Edict. Okay, he's using the Ash Barons, got himself an island, Flint Hawk, sure. Let's get Pestilence out because that's probably more important. And then the next time he taps out, we'll do Guardian. Going and getting himself another land? Oh, another Astro Blade? Okay. So, do they have any main deck answers to this combo? I don't think so. I think that might lock them out. Alright, so we're gonna go play it. Bajuka Bog targeting them. Pass turn. And I think this one's going a lot better. They're thinking about their life decisions.
Maybe he's going through a rough divorce, Josh.
Maybe he is. But why is he playing the Pauper Challenge if that's what's going on?
Or she.
True.
It's
he or she.
Chance
to she. I don't think it's a 1% chance. Maybe like a 5 or 10% chance.
Okay.
There definitely needs to be more like female players of Magic.
See something cool.
Yeah. You're the same person every time. It's beautiful, Chris. It's beautiful. What? Tamir always needs an app. Okay. Seen some movement. Chose to shuffle. Okay, Prophetic Prism. We take two. Swing for two. Play land. Pristine Talisman. Alright, well, I guess we're not gaining life. Okay, sure. Draw some cards. Draw some more cards. We swing. Down to 12. Is he just gonna... Okay, well... So that went much better in our favor. I actually want Castigate. I want some Duresses. I don't like Palace Sentinels, like I said before. Do we bring in Fragmentize? I don't think so, right? Right? No? Deadweight's kind of terrible. Or do we just bring in Fragmentize? Yeah, let's bring in both of those. Take out the other Deadweight and one Journey of Nowhere, since they have... Or actually, we'll keep the Journey. Take out Oblivion Ring, since they'll bring in Enchantment Hate. And let's see how game two goes. We'll keep. We'll probably shamble again, but I might keep. Makes me feel a little bit better. Yep. Okay, well, let's see what he's got in hand right now. Did I not tap that right? Alright, let's not be retarded this time. Okay. So those are both dead. Core Skyfisher is not great. We'll just take out this. Take away part of his dumbass combo. Core Skyfisher. Seeker of the Way. Okay. We'll go land. Play Pestilence. Take four. Okay. Definitely need a way to gain life. Cast a gate. Take out counterspell. Take his draw. Disfigure. Take two. I'm not super worried about that, to be honest. Play that. Return Rainian Fountain. Pass turn.
This way. Oh, I'm done.
Ponder. All right, okay. See what we draw first. Ooh, another pestilence, so I can wipe the field. Not really worry about too much. Nope, not play that. Gain some life. Okay. Gain some life. Pass turn. Gain some more life. Now it's, I think we're just both on top deck mode, which kind of scares me because he has a lot more deck manipulation than I do with Ponders, Preordains, that kind of stuff. So this is a scary situation to be in. The more life I gain, though, the better I feel about this situation. Glint Hawk is a thing. Let's keep the duress. We will go Chainer's Edict on them though. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pass turn. Alright, he's got his draw engine going now. We just gotta make sure not to, you know. Let's wait for him to tap out and then we'll try to cast both of them in the same turn. He's gotta try to progress his build field at some point, you know? Or if we get like another duress or something like that, because we got what, 6, 8, 13 mana? Just keep waiting. We still have 3 duresses and 2 more castigates left, you know, chances to get in the deck. Still waiting for him to do something. Chainer's Edict. Bojuka Bog targeting their discard pile. They're gonna mill out at some point too. Glint Hawk again. Okay. I think we're gonna flashback Chainer's Edict. Yeah. Cause until he forces us to do something else, we're gonna make him do the first move. Alright. So he's got 19 cards left. Where are our artifacts? Like, those would be really good right now. Yep, Mold Drifter's a thing. Sure. Preordain. Okay. So now we'll go Duress first, see what he's got. Counterspell. Then we will go Pestilence. Then we will go Guardian of the Guild Pack. Counterspells that, then we go Guardian of the Guild Pack again, and I think that should block him out of the game. Alright, and we won the match 2-1. Beautiful. Alright, I'll see you guys in the next match. Alright, welcome guys. Yes, I would like to go first. This hand actually seems pretty good. We'll keep this. They mulligan to 6. Gain life. Alright, so we're playing against Tron. Let's castigate. See what he's got here. So we'll take Impulse, I guess. He gonna have turn 3 Tron? He is gonna have turn 3 Tron. Nice. Alright. Need this Guardian out there. Apply pressure. This is not a very, it's not the matchup I really wanted to see. So he's played the snow covered, this one, okay. Okay. Gotta start applying pressure, so we'll put this out there. Gain some life. Attack for 2. I think most likely we're probably going to lose this matchup. It doesn't feel like a great matchup for us, to be honest. Impulse, okay. Impulse is actually not that bad. If he's fetching that, that makes me feel kind of better. With him being tapped out though, I think I'm gonna cast Pestilence next turn. Like I said, apply a little bit more pressure. Or he's not tapped out, he did that at the end of turn. I'm just retarded, obviously. Alright, what you got? Can't cast two in one turn, so we're not doing anything. We'll just swing for 2. Yep, Mold Drifter is a thing. Chainer's Edict. This is not good. I don't feel very secure in this situation. I think we're likely... Yeah, he's just not doing anything. He's just building himself up. Maybe I can get himself to move a mill out. Get ourselves at a high enough life total. That does work technically. Okay. We'll wait to play it. Again, I think we're going the mill route at this point. That is pretty annoying. Yep. Last turn. Yep. pretty sure we lost this game, but I gotta force him to use as much time as possible because timing out is an actual thing. At this point, we're just gonna get rid of this land. It's too much a liability. Pass turn. Gain a life. Try to cast that. Okay. Yield through this turn. There's nothing I can do anyways. We will read the bones, see what we can get. Okay. We will try to gain some life instead then. Discard the land, I guess. Okay. Alrighty, play land. Yield through this turn. Okay. Alright, so we got him to use 10 minutes. We are going to bring in Branced Earth and Castigate and Duresses and the Hill Spell Bombs. So we definitely don't need Dead Weights. Oblivion Ring is probably too slow. Echoing Decay does nothing. Don't need Disfigure. Invocar's Justice is probably too slow. Shave a Pristine Talisman. Second Pristine Talisman. Now we'll shave Pestilence. Artifact Hate probably is good. Shave one more Pestilence and go like that. We'll see if that works. Yes, I'd like to go first. This hand seems pretty good. We'll keep this. Duress. Let's take we'll take away all his mana fixing. We'll do that. Duress, Prism, Castigate. Counterspells that. Okay. Play this. Return a land. Pass turn. Land. And we didn't draw any sort of threats, which kind of sucks. Yep, just Chainer's Edicts and lands. Come on, just draw anything. This is ridiculous. Mold Drifter, sure, whatever. We're gonna lose this game so bad. Chainer's Edict. Ballistica, return a swamp. Let's castigate, see what goes on. Okay. Well, he just gains the 6 life. We'll take Mold Drifter. And play land, pass turn. Island, sure. Now they can go get Tron. Journey of Nowhere. That doesn't. Should have gotten rid of that. Yep. Chainer's Edict. Bajuka Bog, target in his graveyard. Pass turn. Impulse, sure. Sure. Sure, why not? Gain some life. Chainer's Edict him. another one. Okay. Alright, Night's Whisper. We'll see if this resolves. It did not. Journey to Nowhere. Yep. We really need to win this game for him to time out. Like, if we can win this game, then we should win the match. But I don't think we're going to win this game. Duress actually is really good. Because if we can get rid of that Rolling Thunder, right? Yeah, we'll get rid of Rolling Thunder. Yep. Nine, 15, right? 9, 11, 17. He's real close to burning me out. Pulse, sure. Okay. Griffin. Play said Griffin. We need graveyard hate. That's what we need. Graveyard hate right now, I think, would put us over the hump. It's not graveyard hate. Castigate. Prohibit. Well, I think that's pretty much game, but, I mean, we tried. Yep. So that's 10, and then he just kills us. Okay, well, that was fun. Alright, I'll see you guys in the next match. Alright, so Alright, this is a keepable hand. We're just hoping to win out. If we win out, then we can make it into the top 16. If not, like, a chance of the top 8, guaranteed top 16. If we win at least 2, I think that puts us in the top 32. So those are our goals right now, to at least get our stuff back. It hasn't gone exactly the way we wanted to. I think the game, the first game we lost, the first match we lost, was winnable. Yeah, let's Night's Whisper. We're gonna take some damage, but we need some removal. I'm not gonna play Palace Sentinel, so we'll keep the rest. We are not drawing the right removal. That is definitely true. Okay. Well, that's scary. We're in trouble. I need some way to kill this guy this turn. That is not... We are most likely dead. That's, yeah. Yep. Okay. That's game. All right. So we definitely need Fragmentize. And Disenchant. And I like Castigate. And I like having one Circle of Protection red. I don't like Invokar's Justice. I don't like Palace Sentinels. Not a big fan of Disfigure or Deadweights. Echoing Decay, we could hit a log of Frogmites. Bring in another Duress instead, though. Alright, let's do it that way. Yes, I would like to play first. Sure, I will keep. Okay. So we will go dress them. What the f- God damn it. Journey to Nowhere. I draw the worst. Oh my god, dude. Two lands? Like, we started off with... Oh my god. Oh my fucking... Of course. Yeah. Yep. Uh-huh. The rest it's nothing. You know, half the deck. And we're dead already. Holy shit. Like, I just... I hate magic sometimes. Oh my god. Draw a card. Pestilence would have done nothing. Or would have? 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, we've been short one mana on doing anything anyways. Pestilence. Night's Whisper, Pestilence. Where the... So, Journey to Nowhere, that card would have been great. Disenchant, oh my god. We're so terrible at this game. Yeah, I guess the goal is to try to get top 16 now. Talk to you later. Alright guys, yes, we'd like to go first. This hand's okay. We will keep and yeah, we'll go with this. Okay, they're not here. Or... All right. Okay, well, they are good. We will see what they're playing with. All right, we're playing against Mono Red. We'll just take the Fnatic, I guess. I mean, we'll let the Fnatic stay and get rid of the Dasher. They'll go land. I think we'll be able to get Goblin Grenade, right? Play this, return swamp. Okay. Take three. Play land. Deadweight this guy. Castigate them. We can kill that. I think I'm going to take Goblin Grenade. Yeah, Goblin Grenade's what I'm going to take. We'll gain a life. Journey of Nowhere, targeting the cohort. Then next turn we'll put Guardian the Guild back out there. I think that will put us in a pretty good spot. Effectively, we're going to be at 8. After the cards in his hand, of course. Okay, Guardian. Another Guardian. Pass turn. Him drawing land is great for us. Just Chainer's Edict right now. I really want one of the gain life artifacts. We'll see what we get next turn. It might be worth it just to go with Night's Whisper this time. And we will swing for two. Yep. That's what we needed. This will make the game very much in our favor. Okay, he concedes, he saw that. We definitely want Circle of Protection red. Take out one Pestilence, or actually we'll just take out the Palace Sentinels. Maybe another Castigate rather than Read the Bones? Yeah, let's do it that way. Alright. Well, we're mulliganing without a doubt. Mulligan again, go down to 5. Keep this. Get rid of a duress and Pristine Talisman. Done. Divest, take the Burning Tree Emissary, play this, bring this back. Last turn. Down to 11. Up to 12. Chainer's Edict. We're going to take 4, 5, 10 is max, unless he drew. Yeah, 10 damage is all you can do right now. Okay. Not terrible. Take 4. Eight. think we're dead, though. Yeah, because that's five, and then he can Goblin Grenade. Okay. Alright, let's see if we can do this. We also mulligan to five and almost turn the corner, you know? Like, I feel like this matchup is not a terrible matchup for us. It's actually probably pretty good. Yes, I'd like to play first. It's Mulligan. All right, we'll keep this. Keep, we'll get rid of this. Castigate, let's see what he's got here. Smash, Goblin Grenade, Jackal Familiar, Chain Lightning. We'll just take the Chain Lightning, I guess. It's not a very strong hand. Okay, so you drew another one of those, okay. Drew you nowhere. Attacking the, gonna take one of the familiars. Play this. Turn a swamp. Okay, we'll go down to 18, but then I think we stabilize from there. Could just Invokar's Justice. Nah, let's Guardian of the Guild Pact. Castigate, get rid of Goblin Grenade. Pass turn. It's gonna be really hard for him to fight through this at this point. And that's really not going to do much. If he swings, we're probably going to block this Mog Fanatic. Take the 5, wipe the field. So I'll be 13 down to 11 if he attacks. If not, we're just wiping the field and going to 16. Alright, so we just wipe the field and go down to 16. Or 15, actually, I forgot. I didn't calculate that in there. Put him down to 16, and now he's top decking, and we have still 3 cards in hand. Alright, yeah, I think that puts us... Him drawing a land right there is really crippling for him. Let's do this. Read the bones. Bottom. Top. Play a swamp, play a duress, take that out of hand. Now if we just get our life gain, we are pretty much golden. He did not draw anything. We will Knight's Whisper, go down to 11. Circle Protection Red. It should just be overkill at this point. All right. I don't think we can get in the top 16, but if we win the next 2, then we're at least top 32. Get our entry fee back. Yeah. Hey guys. So if we win this, we have a chance of getting the top 32 to get our coins back, but we're not even close to getting the top 16. So, because of tiebreakers. But we're going to try to do this. End up 4-3. I think this hand's fine. We'll keep this. Hopefully it's nothing too aggressive. Affinity, alright. So we will gain 2 life. If he plays anything, we'll just chain his edict next turn. If not, we'll go Ballistica and gain the life back. I mean Ballistica and play it the following turn. Okay. So yeah, we'll straight up chain his edict this. What are you doing? Chainer's Edict. So we'll journey in nowhere that guy now. Thank you. Okay, another ATOG. It's annoying, but... Okay, are we gonna go forward or just sit here? Or... I'm confused. So, Chainer's Edict. Ballistica. If he has artifact into one of the combo pieces, we're dead. So we very well could just be dead right now. That's not a combo piece, okay. Gain some life. Guardian. He lost connection, so it might be a second guys. Alright, he's back. take four. That's fine. Play land. Play Pristine Talisman. Play Guardian of the Guild Pact. Pass turn. Okay, Atog happens. Chainer's Edict them. Jukabog targeting them. Pass turn. Pestilence. Pass turn. Yep, that's fine. Dude, are we dead? For real? Should have done the math. This is so dumb. Alright, well, we'll take Fragmentize, Disenchant, and Circle of Protection Red. Take out Palace Sentinels. Imikar's Justice. Some Pestilence. Run it like that. Oh. Take out Disfigure. I should have had Castigate. Oh, I'm so dumb. Alright, whatever. Mulligan. Keep this. Get rid of one of the Pristine Talismans. Mulligans to 5. If we could top deck a Plains and destroy his land, that might be crippling. Well, I mean, we can destroy a couple lands over the next few turns. Well, we'll just disenchant this guy. Alright, swing at me for two. Sure. Journey of Nowhere, targeting Atog. Gotta hope that's good enough. Take two. Play Guardian. Use that to block. 4/4. Hmm. Yep. It's gonna be backbreaking right there. Oh my god. Hopefully I can start drawing better. Block. Alright, just not land. Please, for the love of God, just not land. Oh my God, dude. Really? Oh my god, is this... So, I'm 13 cards in. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8... Basically 9 lands in the first 13 cards. Like, I would like... Oh my god. I can't believe I'm gonna lose this. Oh my fucking god. So I top deck fragmentized, but I had Disenchant, I had the Guardian, I had Journey to Nowhere, and I think I had the Pristine Talisman. So I've drawn literally Fragmentize, Circle of Nowhere, and the rest, I mean Circle Protection for red, which does nothing right now, and all lands. I hate, oh my god, this is why, oh. Where's all my removal? Oh, there we go. I mean, I wasn't gonna win this game regardless. Like, holy shit. There's the first Trainer's Edict. There's a pocket of, like, good cards. Alright, well, thank you very much for watching, guys. I'm gonna start recording a little bit more. Sorry for the absence. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it, and have a great day.